Without further ado, we welcome you to laugh when you want to laugh, cry when you want to cry, and please have fun as we embark in our journey under the sea in Grantsville High School's production of Disney's The Little Mermaid.
I feel completely new here in the world above. But my life was wrong, and somehow now at last I'm in my own skin, up here in the world above. There's so from this strange new world above.
Steady as she goes, windward ho!
A ship!
I'll tell you a tale of the bottomless blue and its hey to the starboard heave-ho. Brave sailor, beware, cause a biggin's a brewing. Mysterious fathoms below, fathoms below, below, from whence wayward western we blow, where Triton is king and his merciful singing. Mysterious fathoms below.
Isn't this perfection, Grimsby? Out here where the seas meet the skies, surrounded by nothing but water.
Oh yes, it's simply delightful.
The salt on your skin and the wind in your hair and the waves as they ebb and they flow. We're miles from the shore and guess what? I don't care.
As for me, I'm about to heave. Oh.
I'll sing you a song of the king of the sea and its name to the starboard below. Of all of the oceans is the mysterious fathoms below.
King of the sea, why that's nautical nonsense. Nothing but a superstition.
The king of the ocean gets angry. And when he gets angry, beware. I'm telling you, lad, when King Triton gets mad, how the waves all but rock to and fro. Hold on, good luck, as down you go.
What is that?
Lord, please, enough seafaring. You've got to get back to court to honor your father's dying wish and take up his crown.
Suppose I don't want his crown.
And forsake his kingdom and all of his treasures.
Treasures? You mean like mugs? We don't need them. We drink straight out of a bottle, don't we, boys?
Yeah!
Or this? No. Who needs it? I'd rather eat with my bare hands.
Your prince, sire, not a common sailor.
These men are anything but common, Grimsby. They're free, truly free. They don't have to answer to anyone but the sea. I'd rather be a sailor than a prince any day.
This is where I belong. Everything seems more real here. Strange how at home I feel up in the tide's swift flow. And when the pull is strong, I almost think I hear the sea. Wild and
Your Majesty, we ought to head back to shore.
Indeed we should.
Not while I'm captain. Now follow that voice. To the ends of the earth if we have to.
Aye, aye, captain. There's mermaids out there and the bottomless blue and it's hanged to the starboard heave-ho. Watch out for a mad or you'll go to your ruin. Mysterious fathoms below.
In my school, we come up here all the time.
Is that so?
Sure. We're not afraid of sharks, or boats, or fishermen. What's a chum bucket anyway? Are those for real?
You are afraid, aren't you?
No, I'm here, aren't I?
With you. Flounder, you're blushing.
No, it's a sunburn. You get those up here.
Flounder, are you flirting with me?
Gross, blush. No way. But if I was...
Look what I found today. It was floating in the wake of a giant ship.
Cool. What is it?
I don't know.
Airspeed check! Altitude!
But I know just who can check. Tell us.
Landing gear! Check! Clear the runway!
Metal!
Hello, Ariel!
Look what we found today!
Oh, aren't you Well, you called the right bird. I happen to be an expert on that very speciality now, huh?
Can you tell us what it's for?
Oh, this is rare. This is ridiculously rare. And it's in sistine condition.
What is it?
It's a single hopper.
Hopper.
Now I'll give you $2 sand for it.
Scuttle, I'm not selling it.
I'm telling you, get out there in the open ocean, you won't get more than a few clams, but now I'm prepared to offer.
No way. I'm saving it for my collection.
How's about a swap then? I've got something stupidlicious. I mean, museum quality, really. It's a banded, bulbous, shark black. It's second cut into the tuba now.
It makes music?
Sure thing, kid. Now, why ain't just blowing smoke on you? Why it makes music so marvelous, so fantastic?
Music? Oh no! The concert! My father's going to kill me!
The concert was today?
Thank you, Scuttle!
Come on, Flopper.
Vice Metal.
Benevolent merfolk, creatures of the deep. Today marks a special anniversary, for today is the day that I inherited my father's kingdom and banished that sea witch Ursula forever.
Yay!
In honor of the occasion, may I introduce our master of ceremonies.
Priest and Dinar, court composer, Horatio, Polonian, Ignatius, Crescentius, Sebastian.
Morning to y'all.
So tell us, what have you in store?
I've got a special song just for the occasion, and it's going to be performed to none other than your 7 lovely daughters. I wrote this little number for my star people.
And who might that be?
Why, your youngest, Ariel. Such a sweet voice, that child. Notes as clear as ice, pitch as pure as water. Why, I haven't heard such a magnificent sound since, well?
Since her royal highness. May she rest in peace.
You're going to be a proud pappy, you'll see. If only she'd show up for a rehearsal once in a while.
Let the merriment begin!
Oh, we are the daughters of Triton. Great father who loves us and named us well.
What? Adrina,
Athena,
Adela,
Alana,
and Ariel.
Concert behold to enlighten the hearts of the merfolk with music swell.
Aquata,
Athena,
Arista,
Athena,
Adela,
Lorna.
And there is the youngest in her musical debut. Our 7 little sister, we're presenting her to you to sing a song so passionate. Her voice is like a bell.
She's gonna be the death of me, swimming when she should be singing.
If I had that soul, this would never have
that
happened!
That girl's angling for trouble.
I say give her the hook.
Mm-hmm. Are we better than that? Honestly, Daddy, you let Ariel get away with everything.
I love all my daughters equally.
Oh, please, that answer's as canned as tuna and twice as oily.
Mm-hmm. Arista's prettier than Ariel. And Trey is smarter, a lot of sweeter.
Too much to hope for.
Please, sire, don't go pointing your pappy's triton at me.
Oops, sorry, Sebastian.
You might go whipping up a hurricane by mistake.
Well, look what the catfish tracked in.
Ariel, young lady.
I'm sorry, Daddy, I just forgot.
As a result of your careless behavior.
Careless and reckless behavior.
The entire celebration was
ruined, completely destroyed. This concert will be the pinnacle of my distinguished career.
True.
And now, thanks to you, I'm the laughingstock of the whole kingdom.
We gave up a day with a whale of a guy.
I don't sing
Well, Mama loved me best, but she's gone.
Do you mind?
Yeah.
Harry, just please. You've been given such a gift.
Such a gift. I know. My mother's voice.
It's a wondrous talent. One that demands stewardship and care. So please, Harry, for the sake of her memory.
I will, Daddy, I promise.
But it wasn't even Ariel's fault. It was that know-it-all Siegel who just kept going on and on.
Siegel?
Siegel!
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 You went up to the surface again, didn't you?
Nothing happened.
You could have been seen by one of those barbarians. By one of those humans.
They're not barbarians, Daddy.
They're dangerous. Traps and hooks. Like it or not, you're my youngest. My baby. And so I worry about you the most.
Old enough to look after myself.
As long as you live under my roof, you obey my rules.
But if you would just listen to me for once.
And that is the last time you are ever swimming to the surface again. Understood?
You're so unfair.
Check, check, check.
She's headstrong. Will.
Check, 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 check. Okay, we're good. Okay.
Inch and they swim all over him.
I can govern a kingdom, but I can't control my own daughter. I was too harsh. She'll learn to fear me. I don't want that, Sebastian. She needs her mother. And so do I. If only she were here, she'd know just what to say. She'd firmly and yet gently help the girl to find her way. She'd know what to forbid and what we must allow. She'd have the strength and patience that I lack somehow. Oh, what I would give to have her back, right?
It's difficult, sure, but you gotta toughen up, not to melt down. For Ariel's sake, I'm telling you, that child needs constant supervision, someone to watch over her, keep her out of trouble.
That's not a bad idea.
I know.
Someone to safeguard her every move.
Her every dog paddle.
Her every side
step. Her every dive.
And you are just the crowd to do it.
What?
That's right. You heard me. From now on, Ariel, it's your responsibility.
Mine? But your majesty, she is a clever mermaid, and I am just a crustacean. Surely I pick someone higher up on the evolutionary scale.
Oh, mistress of the deep,
beauty of the brine,
you should have seen it. All those merfolk singing Triton's praises and cursing your name.
Declaring a national holiday.
Holiday, my blowhole! It's the day my brother Triton got greedy, that's all. The day he stole my hat of the kingdom.
To think, his very own flesh and blood.
And he double-crossed you.
His very own sister.
Casting you into exile to live a life of shame and unceasing solitude.
Into the shadowy depths of the Serpentine Sea.
No, 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 right! Don't blow your fuses, boys. It should have been mine. All mine.
When I was a kid, a squirmy little squid, I was number seven, born of seven little pearls, pretty as could be, perfect to a T, all except for me,
true, yeah.
Ugly as a slug, hideous to hug, Daddy found me loathsome and disgusting, I could tell, they all got adored, I just got ignored,
Prestige's
guilty magic shell. Used to belong to my Papa Poseidon, full of lethal hexes and spells. My little sea snakes, the perfect gift for a spurned, dangerously unstable child. Most of all, Daddy loved one sister, so feminine, so fresh, so fine. I would watch as he hugged and kissed her, and I hated her guts from the bottom of mine. Daddy's little angel, Daddy's little sweet. Such a little frilly femme. She was seaweed and spice and everything nice. And I dreamed her and I schemed how to put her on ice. Daddy's little angel a girl so heaven sent. Just one spell from the shell and back to heaven she went. Next, what did I do? Daughter number two. Flunger in a whirlpool where I left her spinning round. Daughters three and four washed up on the shore. Sadly, five and six were never found. But that didn't make my father love me.
Aww.
But that didn't bring me down. Oh, no.
No, no.
It was sad, though, when Dad caught that rare and very lethal flu.
So true.
Poor you, Phil Hill.
With no sisters in the line above me, I inherited the whole grand show. Was it fun? Yes, a ton. So much fun. I forgot that my dad also had an additional ton. Yes, his son still ate one. So I figured, so what? Till that snot-nosed little baby grew.
He grew.
And grew. He grew into a man. Trent, a male heir. As soon as he came of age, he stole everything from me. Every ocean, every lake, every pond. Great puddle!
Puddle.
But now, my dear Flossom and Jetson, it's time I take revenge. Revenge on what he loves most. For now he has a child.
Sweet.
But rather wild.
And she has him wrapped around her flimsy little fin. She will be our inn. She'll be what we use. Basie can't refuse. There's no way we'll lose.
Daddy's little angel.
Daddy's little pet.
Daddy's little priceless gem.
So sassy.
So smart.
The key to his heart.
Frowner as it were, it would rip him apart.
Yes.
Daddy's little princess. She's the one to get.
Now to take it from a pro.
I've never felt at home here.
But home's with your family, isn't it?
What if home isn't the place where you were born? What if it's something you have to discover for yourself?
Well, I'd miss you if you were gone.
You would?
Yeah, but not in a dopey way. Not in a crazy, I'm so in love and she doesn't even know I exist way. Not like that at all. I gotta go.
Flounder, you're very sweet. Daddy's never even met a human, yet he still thinks the worst of them. I just don't see how a world that makes such wonderful things could be bad. Look at this stuff, isn't it neat? Wouldn't you think my collection's complete? Wouldn't you think I'm the girl who has everything? Look at this trove, treasures untold. How many wonders can one cavern hold? Looking around here, sure, she's got everything. I've got gadgets and gizmos aplenty. I've got who's it's and what's it's galore. You want a thingamabobs? I've got 20. But who cares? No big deal. I want more. I want to be where the people are. I wanna see them dancing, walking around on those, what do you call them? Oh, feet. Flipping your fins, you don't get too far. Legs are required for
jumping, dancing, strolling along down the, what's that word again? Street. Up where they walk, up where they run, up where they stay all day in the sun, wandering free. Wish I could be part of that world. Like it, if I could live out of these waters, what would I pay to spend a day warm on the sand? Betcha on land, they understand, but they don't reprimand their daughters. Bright young women, sick of swimming, ready.
Trouble in the mind.
Sebastian!
What is all of this?
Oh, nothing. Just a few knickknacks I've collected.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself. If your poor father knew about this place, he...
Oh, Sebastian! You're not going to tell him, are you?
Listen.
He'd never understand.
Listen to me, Ariel. For my sake as well as your own, it's time you kept your mind on your music. From now on, you'll have voice lessons every day. And perhaps you could pick up an instrument. Something ladylike, like the harp practice. A nice harp, man.
A ship.
Decorate with mother of pearl. Ariel? Ariel! Someone's got another girl's face to the floor.
Proper oil, so you're worthy to fill his shoes.
Now you're making me queasy.
And that's not all. I also promised him you'd be married by your next birthday.
Married?
Our kingdom needs a queen.
Have you ever tried taking a princess sailing? It's a joke. Their crinolines get caught in the rigging, and most of them can't even swim.
Swim, sire? Is that a prerequisite?
Sure, if we go sailing. Where am I going to find it, Risby? Someone who's as carefree and alive as the sea itself. Where?
Well, would you look at that now?
Scuttle, be quiet.
Oh, I got your being in trepidations.
It's too much trouble for us. Somewhere out there, a girl who's a match for a guy like me?
Perhaps you're not looking hard enough.
I've never seen a human this close before.
Hey, me neither.
I thought you were an expert.
Well, I mean, on their stuff, sure, but the side of them. I mean, look at that. That square jaw. Those broad shoulders, two eyes of the same color, there's no variety.
I don't know. I think he's kind of handsome.
You do?
Trust me, Grisby. When I come across the girl of my dreams, it's gonna hit me like lightning.
Get on the ring out!
can't make out a heartbeat.
No, look. He's breathing. Oh, Scuttle. Just look at him. He's so beautiful. What would I give to live where you are? What would I pay to stay here beside you? What would I do to see you smiling at me?
You wake him before we divulge!
A voice, somebody, anybody! Get away, you filthy bird! Oh, it's just a door making my pulse race, don't you, dear boy?
A girl rescued me. She pulled me straight out of surf. And she was singing.
Took a terrible tumble.
That voice, I can't get out of my head.
It's the sound of the sea, that's all.
No, I'll prove it to you. I'll find her and thank her for saving my life.
You'd best come back with me. A night of sleep will do you some good.
Please, you have to believe me.
You've heard too many tall tales.
No, she was real.
Of course she was. As real as a siren, as real as a mermaid on the rocks.
Giggles like a fool.
She barely sticks her toe in down at the tidal pool.
It's more than just a face, face it, she's just not herself. Is she ill or insane?
Is it water on the brain?
What has got her bothered so?
It's the bad, the flu.
Gosh, I wish we had a clue.
Oh wait, oh dear, good grief, it's clear she's in love.
Doesn't even speak. She treats me like sashimi left over from last week. You see her late at night, tossing in her ocean bed.
Shoop, shoop, shoop,
shoop. She's shooty as a snapper, oblivious to rocks. You swim right up and tap her. She lays there like a lox. As sure as dolphins fight, something's made her lose her head.
She has lost her head.
And she sighs and she swoons and she's humming little tunes.
Even has a sort of glow.
What on earth could it be?
Any hammerhead can see that side.
That glow, that swoon.
Oh no, she's in love.
Hips, how they swish.
Oh well, don't you wonder who's the lucky seafood dish.
She's in love.
Summer, there's a girl who's like the shimmer of the wind against the water. Summer, there's a girl who's like the glimmer of the sunlight on the sea. Summer, there's a girl who's like the swell of endless music. Summer, she is singing and her song is meant for me. And that voice,
pardon me, my lord. We've been scouring the sea for weeks. And to what end?
I vowed to find her, and I will.
I have a better idea. Host a marvelous ball and invite countless of eligible young ladies from far and wide.
I knew it.
To sing for you.
What?
What better way to find your mysterious voice than to be married that sunset, just as your father decreed?
Yes. Why, yes. That's how we'll find her.
Indeed, we shall. Have my word.
She's out there somewhere. I just know.
I can sense the laughter in the ripples of the waves against the shoreline. I can see her smile on the moonlight as it settles on the sand.
I can see her waiting just beyond the pale horizon, singing out a melody to love me to a whisper.
Thank you. What do they got? A lot of sand. We got a hot crustacean man. Each little clam here, no how to jam here under the sea. Each little slug here, cutting a rug here under the sea. Each little snail here, no how to wear here. That's why it's hotter under the water. Yeah, we are luck here, down in the muck here under the sea. A lot of sand. We got a hot crustacean man. Each little clam here, no how to jam here under the sea. Each little slug here, cutting a rug here under the sea. We got a hot crustacean man here under the sea. Each little snail here, no how to wear here. That's why it's hotter under the water. Yeah, we are luck here, down in the muck here under the sea. You see? Now that's what I'm talking about.
I taught her myself, and now she makes mockery of everything we hold dear. Where is she?
If only I knew.
She keeps secrets from me, Sebastian, not from you. I'll wager you know where she is, so take me to her. So did you?
I had to save the prince.
You had to?
Yes. Without me, he would have perished.
He's a human! You're a mermaid!
But Daddy, you can't judge them just because they're different. Well, maybe you can, but it's not in me.
Different? They catch us with their hooks and they spear us with their blades.
But they're not all like that.
Have you forgotten what they did to your mother?
We can't prove that.
Can there be any doubt? She slips off one morning for an innocent afternoon swim and never returns.
But Daddy, we don't know anything for certain.
I know it in my heart, and that's enough. Murderers, all of them.
But you can't blame all human ones for a few wicked.
I won't have you build a shrine to them, worshiping their rubbish, the debris that sullies our waters.
Daddy.
The totems.
Daddy, no!
Are now decadent.
Daddy!
Never again, Angel. Never again.
No! He'll never break me.
Well, you might just go break his heart.
And you? Some friend you turned out to be? Bringing him here to my secret place?
For your own good, child. I pray you wake up from this madness, and soon you're swimming in some dangerous waters here.
Mm.
doesn't want to know. I hate him, yes, I hate him. Oh, I hate him so.
Poor child.
Poor sweet child.
She has a very serious problem, hasn't she?
If only
there were something
we could do.
Who are you two?
Sweet child.
Poor child.
So tragic.
So misunderstood.
Dear child.
Sad child.
Life's looking,
shall we say,
not good.
No.
Who will ease your woes and worries?
Who will help her get her man?
Sweet child, perhaps the sea witch can.
You can't possibly mean Aunt Ursula.
She knows your dreams.
But Father says her evil
She'll
is
grant me. Your prayer.
She'll cast a charm,
a tiny spell.
Why the alarm?
No one will tell.
No one will care. Sweet child, dear child.
Poor child.
Sad child, we'll bring you to her lair right now. Bet in half a sec your prison you are reconciled. Together.
Forever.
Take me to her.
Sweet child. Mistress of the deep, you've a visitor.
I'm not so sure.
Now, mustn't get cold fits.
Don't be shy, Ariel, darling. It's me, your Auntie Ursula.
I really shouldn't be here.
Nonsense. We're family.
But Father says you're wicked and hateful.
Yes. But he says the same things of the humans, doesn't he, Snookums? And we both know that's not true, don't we?
He doesn't understand me.
Oh, but I do, Dumpling. We're so very alike, you and I. Gals with ambition. Nothing scares a man more, does it? Now tell dear old Auntie everything.
Well, you see, I'm in love with someone. A human.
Oh, yes, this prince fellow. He is quite the catch, isn't he? The answer is simple. You've got to become a human yourself.
Can you help me?
Help you? My dear child, it's what I live for. To help unfortunate merfolk like yourself. Poor souls with no one else to turn to. I admit that in the past I'd been a nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me, well, a witch. But you'll find that nowadays, I've mended all my ways, repented, seen the light and made the switch. True? Yes. And I fortunately know a little magic. It's a talent that I always have possessed. Until lately, please don't laugh, I use it on behalf of the miserable, lonely and depressed, pathetic, poor, unfortunate soul. In pain, in need, this one longing to be thin and that one wants to get the girl. And do I help him? Yes, indeed. Those poor unfortunate souls, so sad, so true. They come flocking to my cauldron, crying spells, Ursula, please. And I help them. Yes, I do. Now it's happened once or twice. Someone couldn't pay the price. I'm afraid I had a right come across the floor. I've been singing to those more unfortunate souls. Here's my best offer, babykins. I know a spell that will turn you into a human for 3 days. Now it's got a procedural clause, sort of a squid pro quo. Before the sun sets on the third day, you've got to get dear old Princey to kiss you. If you do, you'll remain human forever.
And if I don't?
Oh, nothing drastic, dear, I'm sure. Oh, look, small print. Your soul is mine forever, and you're doomed to spend eternity in my watery hell-soaked lair. Lawyers, don't you just love them? Of course, there is one more thing. My fee.
But I don't have any.
I'm not asking for much. Only your voice.
My voice?
But don't worry, I have the perfect place for it. Your grandpappy gave his magic trident to your father. But this was his gift.
Oh, what?
Your magic shell.
You've heard of it? Father says it's the source of all of your power.
Nonsense, darling!
He says you'd die without it.
Die? Please. It's a bubble. A vessel for your voice. Trust me, darling, your vibrato, your legato, even your belt will all be safe and sound in here.
But without my voice, how I...
Your pretty face! And don't underestimate the power of body language! The men up there don't like a lot of blabber. They think a girl who gossips is a fool. Yes, on land it's much preferred for ladies not to say a word. And after all, dear, what is idle prattle for? Come on, they're not all that impressed with conversation. True gentlemen avoid it when they can. But they don't just want to fawn on a lady who's wrong. It's she who holds her tongue who gets the man. Come on, you poor unfortunate soul. Go ahead, make your choice. I'm a very busy woman and I haven't got all day. It won't cost much, just your voice. You poor unfortunate soul. It's sad, but true. Bridge, my sweet, you've got to pay the toll. Take a gulp and take a breath and go ahead and sign the scroll. Lots of jets, and now I've got a voice. The boss is on a roll. You poor unfortunate soul.
So how's about it, Cupcake? But if I become a human, I'll never see my family again. Not my sisters or... even my father.
Do you want your Princey Poo or not? 5, 4, 3, 2.
Yes! Yes, I do. Where do I sign?
But not just any ink, darling. Use mine.
We will now have a 15-minute intermission.
Look who got beached now, huh? There's something different going on here. Now, don't tell me, don't tell me. I'll decipher it for myself now, okay? Oh, you've been using the dingle hopper as your handle, huh, kid?
She's got legs, idiot. She traded her voice to the sea witch and got legs.
Stupid scuttle! Shut up! Not your beautiful pipes, Ariel.
You see? Not a sound.
Now, kid, listen up. That was a lousy swap right there!
What would her father say? I tell you what her father would say. Her father would say he's gonna kill himself a crab! That's what he'd say. She's got just 3 days.
3 days to what?
Make the prince fall in love with her.
Mm-hmm. And to prove it, he gets to, well, I mean, he's got to kiss her.
Well, the prince, eh? You want to snare the prince, you got to learn a graceful way of perambulating.
She'll do no such thing.
Oh, come on now. Sure she will. All righty, Ariel. Upsy-daisy, upsy-daisy. Oh, okay. All righty. There we go. Oh, come on, Ariel. That's not like you. You got to have a can-do kind of attitude. Yeah, you got to have gumption. Yeah, come on now. Take it from a goal, who knows? Now look at me, you see this face? In terms of beauty, I'm a basket case. And as for a style and savoir faire, well, I guess there ain't a whole lot there yet. Although perhaps it makes no sense. I strut my strut, not confidence. Cause though I lack an awful lot, there is one thing I got. I got positivity. I got positivity. It gives me the zam and the zow and the yaddle-addle-addle. That's why I walk with the wiggle in my waddle. And once you've heard that word, there ain't nothing you can't do. So let that positivity work for you.
Positivity? Why, there's no such word.
Oh, sure there is. It's right between popsicle and pre-hysterical in the dictionary. Believe you me, I've seen it work miracles.
Bip-bidi-bop-bop-boo, you can flip and you flap till your wish comes true. The tip is a tap into something that you believe.
Cause with the zig and the zog and the zizzer-z, there ain't nothing you can't be. You see, it's really your prerogative. You simply can't be negative. Then there's you just sitting there, smack down flat on your derriere. If that's the way you wanna be, well, you might as well be shrubbery. So stand right up and dust your seat. Walk real tall upon your own 2 feet. And show your trip and make mistakes. But you've got what it takes. Oh, come on now, Ariel. Come on. Oh, there we go. There you go. Oh, come on now, Gary. Watch this, watch this. See, you gotta do this. And then a whole lot of that. This is the hard part right here. You ready? Woo-hoo-hoo. Took me months for that one right there. All right, you ready? You ready? It's gonna be your turn. Yeah, there you go. There you go, Ariel. There you go. You're getting the hang of it. All right, it's gonna be your turn here soon. Sebastian, get away. Let's go now, Ariel. Let's go. Oh, my gosh. Let's take her away, Gold! Ah! Alrighty, Ariel, here we go! Gold, lift her away! There you go, that's the basics right there, that's the basic. Oh, you idiot! Oh my. Alright, 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 no, okay. Alright, you saved her that time, I'll give you that.
Can't do
so publicity. You can bet on electricity and that positonomy? What is it?
Positivity!
Have we met before?
Why, yes, of course. I've been looking for you everywhere. Please, you must tell me. What's your name? Oh, I'm sorry, you don't speak English? Sore throat, eh? You don't speak at all, do you? For a moment, I mistook you for someone else. What is it? You're hurt? No, no. You need help. A bit dizzy, aren't you? I had just the remedy. Or back in a hot meal. Come on now. The palace isn't far.
Oh, now that's what I call reeling him in, Ariel!
It's gonna get me into the real hot water.
Can you believe that guy won a crown? And now you know that word. There ain't nothing you can do.
Do what you must to make it presentable. Scrub in the tub, a proper frock.
We're helping her get a strength.
Can't help but to wonder what she must be thinking. Give her father your answer, just hear her thoughts.
Beyond my wildest dreams.
He's here, mobs galore, and even more. Gee, did I mention he's here? And who knows, all of it goes past even these extremes.
Well, now I'm the one who's speechless. Hungry?
Attention, attention. Le menu, lobster bisque. Do not attend, ce soir il cargo. Hold the mic, maintenant! La la, zoom da, bri, la ri, la ra 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 ri, di, la ri, ri, ri. Les foisons, les poissons,
hello!
Les poissons, la tout ça!
Et tu sais, les tout fisques.
First I cut off the head. Then I pull out the bone. I may whip sauce to go to this. Les poissons, les poissons.
Hey!
Oh, and the cleaver, I hack them.
Oh! I pull out what's inside,
and I save it up fried. God, I love
little fishes, don't you?
Mwah. Here's something for tempting the palate. Preparing the classic technique. First you pound the fish flat with a mallet.
Then you slash the skin.
Get the mallet off the line.
Then you rub some pork in. Because that makes it taste nice.
See the lore I miss. Sacre bleu.
What is this?
How on earth could I miss such a sweet little succulent crab? Panamas, what a lot. You belong in this sauce, and some flour, I think, just a dab. Then I'll stir you with bread in your hand.
You'll be dead.
And surely be lucky you are, cause it's gonna be hot.
Ooh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
In my big silver pot. Toodaloo, mon poison. For a
Prince Eric, it's been a while, hasn't it, since we dined in the company of such lovers?
Usually it's just me and Graham. He has to look across the table at my ugly mug.
Well, that certainly worked its wonders. She's a full groom, you might say.
Easy, old boy, easy. My, isn't that unusual? Thank you.
Don't tell me she's fond of tobacco. Ah, it's the pipe. Can't say blame you. Sad teeth, more shunt from Zuzo.
Sorry, old friend, but it looks like the pipe smoked you.
Yes, very amusing. I'm glad she certainly knows how to make you smile. Shall we?
Thank you.
Look at the two of us, eh? What a couple of misfits. You're a quiet girl in a noisy world, and I'm a prince. Much rather be a simple sailor. We're both fish out of water, you and me. I'm sorry. Did I say something wrong? Who needs words anyways? A smile says just as much sometimes. Nibble on your feet, aren't you? Dancing beats small talk any day. Why, sure. It's the way your feet smile. Or laugh. It lets you say so many things.
Dancing is a language that is felt instead of heard. You can whisper, sing, or shout without so much as a word.
Try it. Go on.
Like so. Just let your emotions tell your body what to do. See how much a single gesture can reveal. And every little step, every single step, is one step closer to saying what you feel. Once the music hits you, inhibitions fall away, and you find that you're expressing things your voice daren't say. Don't be afraid, let go. Surrender what's inside, we'll sleep on through. As the boundaries between us disappear, and every little step, every single step, is one step closer to talking loud and clear.
Into the fire. The things
things I do for you, young lady. Now I know what I should do. I should march you right back to your father, so you can be miserable for the rest of your life. All right, it's true. I've got no backbone. All right, child. I'm in. Now we've got to make a plan to get that boy to kiss you. You've got to bat your eyes like this. Yeah, and you've got to puck your lips like this. Sure. And if you put those two things together, you'll have the boy in the palm of your hand. Now come, child. Off to bed with you.
That was too close!
For comfort, boys. One day! And already they're dining together.
And dancing cheek to cheek?
I should have known! There's only one thing more potent than my black magic.
The power of true love!
Teenage hormones! But
peaceful, isn't it? Not another living soul for miles.
Nothing is happening!
They spent all morning on horseback, then a picnic, now this, and not so much as a peck on the cheek.
So, how about this weather?
Really, the weather line?
This is going nowhere fast.
Poor Ariel, 24 hours and he'll be married off and she'll be deep sick.
We've got to do something, and quick.
But what?
We've got to create the right kind of mood.
All right. Hear me out on this, okay? You ready? Something romantical.
Yes.
That's the part right there, okay? Candlelight?
Yes.
I thought of that one myself.
Yes.
All righty, here we go. And shampoo! Woo-hoo-hoo.
Oh my gosh. Nonsense! It don't take all of that. Everything we need, we've got right here. Percussions, strings, winds, and words.
Yes, you want her.
She don't say a word and she won't say a word until you kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, don't be scared. You got the moves prepared for that kiss the girl.
Wow, wow.
Sha-la-la-la-la-la, don't stop now. Don't try to hide and how you wanna kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, flow so long and listen to the song. Someday kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la, music play. Do what the music say. You gotta kiss the girl. You gotta kiss the girl. You wanna kiss the girl. You gotta kiss the girl.
You gotta kiss the girl.
Ariel, are you okay?
Sebastian, what was that?
Lightning?
From underwater?
Must be some kind of freak storm. We ought to get back.
Tomorrow's my birthday, and Grizzly's holding a contest. We better get going. Grizzly wants me married by sunset. Where else?
She'd be so angry if she knew I were here.
I entrust my youngest daughter to you, and what happens? I ought to have you cracked. I ought to have you shelled.
He almost was, your greatness, and all for Ariel.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself, too. What kind of tragedy will it take?
A tragedy involving the sea witch, to be exact.
Well, you see, these two eels came and they took Ariel straight to Ursula, and then she traded her voice for a pair of legs, and now if a prince doesn't kiss her...
She traded away her voice to become human?
By sunset tomorrow, she could be giving away her very soul.
Her soul?
And also that wicked sister of yours.
It's time I sell things for first woman to draw.
Pardon me, madam. Is there anything else you require before bedtime? Very well. Best we catch 40 winds. Hey, Lady Mother, the circumstances are right. Mustn't look so blunt. Seek her to happiness as well. You mustn't wish for impossible things.
In my every
only I knew how I'd make him see the light. If only it were up to me, this all would turn out right. And if I only knew, I'd tell him what I'd do. I'd simply wave me claw and make my dreams come true. And wouldn't that surprise you if you only...
How could I have pushed you to the point, having no one left to turn to? What if I have lost her and it's all my fault? She's gone.
The sun has nearly set. Your birthday is nearly over. You must choose one. Perhaps if we seal ourselves, take another listen.
Ariel?
Oh, for heaven's sakes, child, you mustn't.
Grimsby, wait and listen. Go ahead, Ariel.
Poor lost child.
I'd so hoped, Eric, that you might find love somewhere in this room.
Perhaps I have. I've just been too blind to see it.
That's impossible. She had a lot of sound.
No, that's funny. Because I heard every single note, as clear as a bell. That's up to something, doesn't it, old boy?
Perhaps it does. Another contestant.
That's it. That's the voice.
Oh, this is much more expected.
Till that's too late. Till the record competition's over.
Get ready to spend the rest of your days as her slave.
Like the barnacles on her back.
Ursula!
Oh, darling. Right on.
What have you done with my daughter?
Nothing. She's done it all herself. Trading her voice away. And for what? Human heartbreak.
Give Ariel back to me.
Not on your life. It so happens that your daughter signed a contract.
No.
Even drew a little heart upon the eye. Is it binding? Goodness, yes. Unbreakable. Unless. There is a little something we could try.
Go on.
Yes, perhaps we could arrange a sort of trade-off. Maybe swap your daughter's soul for, say, your own.
What?
Sign a scroll and set her free. Or else she comes with me to suffer through eternity alone. The mute little hatchling. Drowning in her own sorrow, with no voice to cry out your name. Well, I'm waiting.
It's not my soul you're after. It's my power.
What would you rather be? King of the sea or father to his little girl? And now, you poor unfortunate soul, time's up. You're through. All the power of Poseidon has been once again made whole. All the magic of the trident and the shell in my control. And now dark shall reign forever over ocean, sea, and shoal. Now see for yourself how banishment feels. You poor, unfortunate soul.
Look out!
Down the shelf! The spell is broken. Give me back my shell.
If it breaks, you die.
You believe that? After all the lies he told you.
Lies? What lies?
You told that the world above was hideous. And what was it instead?
Beautiful. It's beautiful beyond compare.
He'd say anything to turn you against your prince and his kind. He's shameless! He'd even say they murdered your mother.
Wait. What?
It was you, wasn't it? All this time I've been cursing them when it was you!
What? I hadn't heard a minnow! You're a liar! No!
I'm the one who's at fault, cursing humans when all along...
There's goodness in people, Daddy, I know. I've
proud of you, Mary. Your mother would be too. In the blink of an eye, when my back was turned, you grew up. You love me very much, don't you?
It's what she wants, Your Majesty, more than anything, please.
You belong to his world now.
Sunrise to search for her again.
Your Majesty, she is lost.
I won't rest until I've found her.
Sire, what?
Ariel? Is it true? It's been your voice this whole time, hasn't it?
Astonishing, I must say, why it defies plausibility.
Your Majesty, at last I found someone who makes me eager to seize my future and claim my birthright as king. But if I slip out to sea sometimes, I don't think she'll mind, because she'll be right there next to me, keeping us both on course. With your permission, sire, I'd like to make her my wife.
My permission? Ariel can speak for herself.
Yes, yes, Eric, oh yes!
After bedtime. Oh, that's a bad idea.
Are you the young man's father?
Heavens no, His Majesty's long dead. I'm his guardian, nothing more.
Well, I wish his father would be pleased with you. Both.
It's my one shining achievement in the dark world.
Congratulations to us both, my friend.
Indeed, to you.
If only you could stay, never say goodbye. If only I could make time stop, leave me, I would try. But fathers have to learn that daughters have to grow. And if you truly love them, you just let them go.
Oh, my love, so you could know.
Tall tales and superstition, eh, Grin?
So he's really the king of the sea and she's his daughter.
Does that bother you?
Heavens, no. I'm just relieved his loyalty.
Just you and me.